Hello guys, today we will see bioisosterism. Bioisosterism also plays an important role, also an important physicochemical property which is required for showing better biological activity. So if any compound or any drug is not showing better biological activity, then we can replace with new functional groups and then we can increase its biological activity. So that is the basic definition of bioisosterism. Isosterism is having vital importance for showing better biological activity. What is isosterism? Means similar type of functional groups we are replacing and we are increasing its biological activity. So that phenomenon if we are doing, then we'll call it as bioisosterism. Fredman has given one definition. According to Fredman, he proposed a definition of bioisosterism as the phenomenon by which compounds usually fit with similar functional groups. So this similar functional groups we'll call it as isosteres and possess the same type of biological activity. So this complete phenomenon is called as bioisosterism. Replacement of functional groups with new groups often increases biological activity or fails the biological response. Means if already present functional groups are not showing better biological activity, then we'll replace with the new groups. So sometimes after replacing with the new groups, it may increase the biological activity, or it may decrease the biological activity, or it will show the inactivity. Bioisosteres or functional groups or molecules that have chemical and physical similarities producing similar biological activity. What are bioisosteres? Means which functional groups we are replacing or which molecules we are replacing, that groups we will call it as bioisosteres. So this bioisosteres are having similar physical and similar chemical properties, and also they will produce similar biological activity. So this bioisosteres are of two types. First one is classical bioisosteres and second one is non-classical bioisosteres. In detail we'll see in the next slide. What is classical bioisosteres? Classical bioisosteres means they have similar shape and configuration of atoms, groups and molecules which they replace. So when they are replacing with the new groups or atoms or functional groups or any molecules, they contain the similar shape like the previous one. Okay, you can see here, this is the example. This is structure of uracil and it is structure of fluorouracil. Uracil is a pyrimidine 2,4-dione. So in this uracil, the first position starts from here and second position, third position, fourth and fifth. So in the fifth position, there is a hydrogen atom. This is the structure of uracil. So this uracil is not showing anti-neoplastic activity. When we are replacing this hydrogen, which is a atom, so replacing with the hydrogen with fluorine. You can see at fifth position, the fluorine has been replaced with the fluorine atom is introduced in the place of hydrogen. So this is structure of fluorouracil. This fluorouracil is showing better anti-neoplastic activity. So this is how we can replace the new functional groups and we can increase its biological activity from the previous biological response. Next one is non-classical bioisosteres. They do not have steric or electronic configuration property and do not have the same number of atoms as replacement. Means they do not have the same number of electrons. So previous classical, in case of classical, one atom is replacing with the another atom, or one monovalent atom is replaced with the monovalent another atom. But here we are replacing with another molecule, we are replacing with the another compound, and this particular group doesn't have any similarity in the steric factor. Means steric factor means in the three-dimensional shape configuration, and electronic configuration means number of the electrons present in the orbital. So that property is not having any similarity, and they do not have the same number of atoms as replacement. Here this is the example, isoproterenol. Isoproterenol contains OH group. Here, soterenol contains SO2CH3NH group, means it is a sulfoxide methyl amino group, means sulfamoyl methyl group we can say. So this group is present, but here two atoms are there, one is oxygen and another one is hydrogen, but here it contains completely different configuration and completely different in the number of atoms also. And compared to isoproterenol, soterenol will show the better biological activity. So this is non-classical bioisosteres. Classical bioisosteres are again categorized into monovalent classical bioisosteres, divalent classical bioisosteres, trivalent and heterocyclic compound and so on, but we are not discussing in detail in this video. Thank you.